Hey friends, welcome back to my channel. If you've been building with Cursor AI like me, you've probably noticed some things frustrating. Cursor forgets a lot, like a lot. You write some code today, right? And then poof, it's gone from its memory. It starts to hallucinate and even start to suggest wrong suggestions and even sometimes delete some of the code it helped to implement just some iterations ago. Today, I'm going to show you a simple way to fix that problem by connecting Cursor to something called SuperMemory MCP. Basically, an external memory bank that helps Cursor remember your past work so it doesn't forget or get confused. We'll set it up together in under like 5 minutes and I will show you it in action, right? Also, if you're more advanced and like self-hosting, I'll mention another option, right? The HPKV memory server. But today demo, it's all about the super memory because it's easy to start with, right? Even for vibe coders. If you like this tutorials, hit the like, subscribe, and let me know your thoughts in the comments. If you don't care about the reason why it works, if you don't care about the deep dive and just want to skip to the demo, you can use the time stamp on the screen to switch to the next section of the video. Else, let's get into it. A quick background so you understand why this works. Cursor AI has what we call the context window. It can only see a limited chunk of your code base at once. As your code base grows bigger, old stuff falls out of that window. Cursor forgets it's like working with a forgetful teammate. And that's why after a few iterations or a big project, Cursor starts to hallucinate and confuse itself. The solution is connecting Cursor to an external memory server, a place where it can save important facts and instructions outside of the context window. Then every time you prompt it, it can fetch relevant past info and behave smarter. Yes, that's what MCP servers can do. And SuperMemory.ai is the easiest one to set up. Before we jump into the setup, right? MCP actually means Model Context Protocol. It's like essentially a plugin system that lets Cursor connect external servers or tools. It doesn't have to be about memory. There are a lot of MCPs out there. Some of them are like plug and play, like just the one about to show you. And there are others that you self-host and you have to do like some extra, you know, configuration. If you navigate to this repo, right? You see it on the screen. If you navigate to this repo, you'll be able to see all the other like options and a lot more. But don't worry, once you learn how to set up this one, basically, you already know how to set up most of them. Today, we're going to be focusing on the super memory. So, I have this project, right? An empty project. Now, I'm going to show you guys what happens when you don't have this hack. Create an HTML file, welcoming people to my YouTube channel, right? And my target is old people, right? So, I want no text font size below 30 pixel, so make them big, right? We have this all nice, so we can accept and we can check this with the live server. And we can see if we check this with live server, we can see everything is huge, right? Now, if I come back to Cursor and say, open just a new chart, right? And now tell it to add a span. Add the span somewhere in the body, right? So you can see it's added just 3 lines. And if I accept and I go back there and I refresh, I will get a tiny. Now, this goes against what I said about my project being for old people. So how do we fix this? And this time we're going to be adding the MCP server. So first thing first, you have to navigate to this. Right, you have your own unique URL. This is not the one I'm using because I do not want to go to the stress of editing and hiding the key, but yours will be unique to you, right? So you could copy the URL from here, and when you get here, you navigate to settings, right? So let me close this so you see how you get it. Click on settings, MCP, right? And you click on add new global MCP. So I'm just going to paste this here. I'm going to keep this like available on the Telegram channel and in the, like, all description, right? So that you, if you need to get this,
so you can get put your URL, the server name and whatnot, and it saves automatically. Second thing you can see, it already shows that we have this MCP server available, and it's as simple as that. The second thing you need to do is come to the rules and add this room, right? That tells it to always check for tags and add tags to the memory, right? And I think that should save the rules there, right? Everything is good. So let's close it. You can see empty project, right? And I'm just going to repeat the exact same steps. So I'm going to tell it to create the HTML file, right? So if we come here, we should see same thing like before, right? Subscribe button, description and whatnot, right? And nothing here is less than 30 pixel. And now we would see that it will add that memory back. So things to user preference, right? Right, large font, minimum 30 you get. Mm-hmm. If we come now this time and now like start a new chat, right? And say add this part, right? And say add this part, send food, right? We would see that it's going to actually like check the memory and know that everything must be minimum of, you know, 30. So you see, user wants minimum 30 pixel. You can see, right? So it will add the span, yeah. And do you see the difference? People of God, did you see the difference? Sorry, not people of God. Friends, do you see the difference? Now it came. So let's preview this. Let's preview this. So, and now you see it's added that, okay, to memory. So it checks the memory before and implements, then adds, you know, a summary of what it did to memory. This is a new chat. You guys can see, right? You can see this is a new chat. And if you come back here, let's come back here. This is the previous one that was done, right? And we can see that I added it this way. If we go and refresh, I don't want to refresh here, so we still have a copy of this, right? If we, you know, right, paste to refresh, we can see the send food is big, and you can see the previous one, the send food is small. So when I say we fixed the problem, we solved the problem, I was serious. I was serious. All with the help of, you know, the MCP tool. Like, and so see, there are so many tools out there, so many of them. It's not just this MCP, right? There's so many other MCPs out there that can do so many powerful things. I want you guys to, you know, check the comment section. Like in the comment section, if there's any other MCP tool you've tried, you can see the history, right, of the conversation, right? Don't worry, like you can see like it has as a saving it. And if you don't want your data to be saved or something, like maybe after some time, you can come here and delete that memory. Right, for me, I'm not gonna be using this account because it's open on YouTube. The whole stuff is on YouTube. But I'm saying, if you get my point, right? No more insinuation, no more deleting your futures, no more like adding what you get, no more changing your TypeScript React projects to JavaScript. If you're a developer would like self-hosting and have more control over your data, right? If you don't save it in like an external server, the MCP called the HPKV memory server, right? That one allows you self-host locally, right? So you could set that up, and maybe in future I will cover it in a future, in a video, if enough people are interested, right? So if you just leave a comment that you want to see how to set that up, I could make a dedicated video just for that. But for this super memory is really easy to use, so we should be able to set it up with vibe coders, should be able to set it up easily. So that's it for today. Now you know how to set up cursor from forgetting your work and hallucinating all over your project. If you found this useful, drop a like, subscribe, and join our Telegram community. And please, I noticed you guys have been engaging so much on the Telegram community. I drop one video, you see 200 comments and 6 comments on YouTube. Please, if it's working for you, leave a comment on YouTube also. Yeah, thank you. Happy vibe coding. See you next time.